last year, and this is actually pretty public knowledge, my husband had a horrible PTSD episode. That night specifically was a very traumatic night. Nobody expected it. It just came out of the blue. But the tape around, nobody can go to the house. And all 12 girls were at my sister's house and were like, what can we do? And so the moment that the tape was gone and, you know, the authorities had left, they were in my house cleaning my house. I feel so alone. I mean, we're in the middle of a pandemic and studies are showing, I'm hearing this constantly, everybody feels more alone than they ever have in their lives, right? I'm blessed enough to be able to say, yeah, I don't feel alone because I know for a fact I've got now, at this point, almost 30 women that I can call on at any moment and be like, hey, life's not okay. Help me.
And I just gotten out of an abusive relationship and, you know, when I got out of it, the only goal I had in life was just to say yes to any opportunity that I could. I just felt so free and like able to express myself in ways that you just don't get to otherwise. It's like this unspoken release of energy where you don't have to like try to articulate or to communicate what it is that you're going through. You just get to be wherever you're at. I mean, who was that girl? What isn't different? Wow. I mean, she was really lost. I was really lost at the time. I didn't know what I wanted. This has provided me with so much direction and excitement.
My partner and I were trying to adopt, and we went through the entire process, had the baby, and the mother ended up changing her mind. And so when we came back with full compassion and understanding for the situation, and yet still grieving, and this team took care of us. They literally fed us for a month. I mean, they allowed the space and the love that we needed that we didn't even know we needed.
Yo he ayudado a mi familia por un proceso migratorio muy largo. Yo he ayudado a mi familia financieramente. Y ha sido, he tenido que trabajar muy duro para poder ayudarlos. Y el baile ha sido como mi escape de tener que ser como la persona que ha ayudado a mi familia por todo ese proceso. El proceso migratorio es muy largo y a veces es muy emocional. Y cuando yo vengo al estudio y entro en la pista de baile y es como que todas esas emociones y a veces tristezas se derriten.
When they're powerful, this might sound selfish, I'm powerful, and when I'm powerful, and then when they're powerful, their family's lives are powerful, and their family's lives, so it's just, again, this ripple effect of positivity.